I have many rich people in India. They must have done very good karma in last birth. But in this birth, many of them cheat and earn money by not paying tax, etc., and don't help the poor. I fail to understand about their positive balance.
Okay.
That's a very important question, because we see this every single day. We see the poor, we see the great gap and the wider divisions between the poor and the rich.
Okay, this is a very important thing to address, and I would like to address it again and again. The reason why we have such a vast difference between the heaven and heaven notes in India is as follows. This is my conclusion. You see, when we don't understand something that we really have discovered, spirituality, this wonderful thing called Dharma, Hinduism, when you don't understand it, if it is misunderstood or poorly interpreted, it can create serious problem in our society. The very thing that should help us becomes seriously counterproductive and does tremendous harm. Let me tell you how this harm is, why we have this big difference. The Hindus have not understood the law of karma in its totality, in its complexity. The law of karma says not only what you do is going to come and catch up with you, if you see an issue in front of your eyes and you fail to address it, it's going to come and bite you as well. The Hindus say, no, when you see a big difference with heaven, heaven, or suppose you reach, you know, have a rich Indian friend say, but what about these poor people starving outside your door? Do you know what he'll tell you? Guaranteed, he'll say, oh, their karma catching up with them. Mr. Lakhani, why are you bothering? Let them starve. Let we go and have fun because we have done good work in our last life. What nonsense. The law of karma says, when you see an issue in front of your eyes, you address it. So if there's a big difference, you must address the issue, reduce the difference. You can't completely demolish it, but reduce it. Make it more sensible. Why? Because in the next life, I'm telling you, those rich people are dancing about without bothering with the poor people. These people are going to be reborn at the bottom rung of the society, and there'll be other people who are poor will be born at the upper rung of society and be dancing around, and yet you're not solved the problem. So they will pay a price because they'll be reborn there. It's just a matter of chance, simple as that. So the idea of not addressing issue that you see in front of your eyes is a very nasty thing we are doing in the name of law of karma. We are bypassing this issue of addressing the issue of severely handicapped, you know, struggling people by saying, oh, nobody deserves it. In fact, it is your job to sort it out and not blame these people who are struggling.
Actually, I personally have experienced people telling me that it is your karma that you are in this position, and no matter how hard somebody tries, they can't move up or whatever, and it is just karma that is blamed, when in fact it is us we should be blaming ourselves. It is the humans that have brought this upon ourselves.
We have not taken the responsibility, because law of karma says you are responsible for chiseling your own future. So it says issue arises in your own personal life, things gang up against you, come fighting. So no, I will sort myself out. What karma? Things are going to gang up against me anyway. Lots of things kind of, you know, hit me all the time. So I have to kind of stand up against it and sort myself out. This is the positive idea of law of karma. Not being a fatalist saying, oh, I deserve it. Who? Nobody deserves it. Stand up and sort yourself out.